Good morning and welcome back to Outlook Portland. I'm your host, David Bragdon. My guests are Monica Smiley from the Tualatin River Keepers and Bridget Cook from Adelante Mujeres. And we've just been talking about the importance of access to the Tualatin River in terms of getting people actually out there.
Right.
And that's an important part of your mission. One of the ways you're going to do that on June 28th is Discovery Days. Seems kind of funny to talk about discovering something that's, you know, literally right in our backyard. But
right.
It is a discovery for a lot of people. They don't know the Tualatin River is there. So what can we expect to have happen on the 28th?
June 28th, we'll be launching 250 or so people in canoes and kayaks on the river. They're not going
to
just launch them straight
on. Slingshot or something. Cannons.
No. When people find our organization and they find the Tualatin River, they do, for the most part, because of our Discovery Day event. And what it is it's a self-guided paddle. Our volunteers have prepared a route that's actually not one that's very accessible because it doesn't have a public put-in point. Most of the public put-in access points have a very level access point that's been paved
what
or graveled. And these ones are, we're putting in docks for this event specifically so that folks can see a spot that they haven't necessarily seen.
So where would they come to on the 28th? And then also just more generally, what are the good places to get into the Tualatin River?
Okay, well on the 28th we'll be paddling in the town of Shoals. And it's near, our access point is called Eagle Landing, and it's near Groner Elementary School. All the information is on our website. We're launching folks every 2 minutes. And so you can...
This is like NASA or something
right,
here.
Right, we like to keep things organized.
Yeah.
But that keeps people spaced out. And like I said, it's self-guided. Everyone gets a guidebook that talks about natural history along the trip. But other spots that are great to go paddling, City of Tualatin has fantastic access points. There's one in in Forest Grove or in Hillsborough and in Tigard. So there's great easy places to get on the river, and there's rentals right at Browns Ferry Park.
So it's easy. Was your trip easy? How was your first trip?
I can't remember exactly where we launched.
We were at Cook Park in Tigard.
Right, with our Rumbo al Rio. This is an event we have coming up with Tualatin River Keepers. Al Rio. You gotta roll those R's for
roll
that
us.
One.
Yeah.
Heading down to the river, basically, is the translation. And that's our opportunity for our families and some other collaborating partners to get down on the river with Tualatin River Keepers, and we do a tracking event with the kids.
Nature,
what else are
we
gonna
do?
We
have a picnic and we get out on the river
right.
It's our volunteers working with the women and many, many children. There was over 100 people there last year.
Many little ones,
right.
It can get a little crazy, but.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
I'm sure everybody's got their life jackets on. And
so, but some of this then does tie to your work, too,
definitely.
That relates to identifying species of plants that shouldn't be there and ones that should be, and some of the restoration work. And
right,
I wanted to talk a little bit about that part of your mission, because it is great to get out there on a Saturday. But there's also a lot of work that goes on around the year where you've enlisted people. Once you've made them aware of it, you go out. Can you describe some samples of some of the restoration projects where you take out things that shouldn't be there? And
sure. Well, Monica can talk about the specific sites.
Well, we've worked with Bridget's group specifically at several natural areas in the Tualatin watershed, planting native species and removing invasives to create wildlife habitat and preserve floodplain.
And are these are also kids, or this is the whole wide range of generations?
Right. For the most part, we have the moms, and then there are toddlers and preschoolers. So they're having a great time helping to use a shovel and putting the trees in, or pulling out invasive species, and discovering salamanders and snakes and anything that they can come across.
And the River Keepers has a tool bank that you share with other civic groups or school groups that are out there. What are some of the other groups that you're working with that get enlisted and excited about this sort of thing?
Oh, a lot of school groups and businesses come out to do restoration, and we loan the equipment to other groups who, or cities even, that need more tools to accommodate a group or a large group, or they're having a big event.
Right. So there's a lot to do for a lot of different types of people out along the Tualatin River.
There's a lot of ways to be involved.
Great. Well, we'll talk about that a little bit more when we come back after this break on Outlook Portland.
Outlook Portland will continue in a moment.